Hi students, very good morning. Yesterday in the previous session, we have discussed with respect to Nernst equation, right? Nernst equation is nothing but it can be written like this. Once again, I am writing Nernst equation. Something like delta G will be equal to delta G naught plus RT ln K e to the power. So we should be very cautious with respect to this one. So what is K e to the power? Suppose we have every reaction A plus B.
Okay, this is the result. So, here mentioned F plus 2 constant.
reactants. Okay. So E okay. E naught of carbon. We are getting reduction potential. E naught of cell. Sorry. E naught of carbon. How much? Here we get as minus 0.45 minus 0.059 by L. How many electrons are being involved? We are getting 2 electrons, right? So it is 2 log. What is product? Product is this one. So it is I by reactant. With this one, Fe plus 2. Okay? We know that for solid, already has it. For solid, we will be taking one. So this one, value is 1. Concentration of iron. Concentration of Fe plus 2 is, this is 0.1. Okay? So if I solve this, in order of capital will be minus 0.45 minus 0.059 by 2 log 1 by, this is 0.01. 0.01 means 10 power minus 2. If it comes to the top, what happens? Minus 0.45 minus 0.059 by 2. It becomes log 10 square. Log 10 square is nothing but 2 log 10. Log 10 you know value 1, so it is minus 0.45 minus 0.059 by 2 into 2 log 10. You know this value is 1, 2 will be cancelled, so it is minus 0.5 minus 0.059. So what you get in minus value? So take 905. So answer will be minus 0.509 volt. Getting me, he has given only one electrode. So you have to what? This is reduction potential, but this is reduction potential, what you have written. So this is the reduction potential. So this is the reduction potential. If you want the oxidation potential, so if you want oxidation potential, it is plus 0.509 volt oxidation potential. Getting me? So this one will be X. You are getting reaction potential and the reverse, if you change the side, this oxidation potential. Right? In the same way, you are having one more model, same problem, same model, you solve this question. Right? Pass the video and try to solve the question. Okay, so then I am explaining this. What strategy that is? Question is like this. Find the reaction potential and oxidation potential of chromium to chromium plus 3. It has given a complete deficit. What is this? Chromium plus 3 is chromium. Okay? Chromium plus 3 is chromium. Means what? Oxidation or reduction? Chromium plus 3 to chromium. How many electrons does it require? It requires 3 electrons. Okay? So here to here, reduction, decrease in oxidation state, reduction is nothing but. Cathode, you not have reduction region. Just the reduction value only chromium plus 3 to chromium. Decrease, right? You not have reduction value. Minus 0.059 by L log product. Product is chromium reactive is chromium plus 3. Okay? That means so. So chromium plus 3 concentration is how much? 0.1. Okay? So E cathode is going to reduce how much? Minus 0.75 minus 0.0. Instead of 5.96, 0.06 by L not across 3. Log. Chromium is solid, so it is 1. Chromium plus 3. Concentration is 0.1. So, if I solve this, minus 0.75, minus 0.06 by 3, you will be getting what? Log. This is 1 by 10 power minus 1. 10 power minus 1 means you will be getting 10 power 1. 10 power 1 is nothing but 10. So, minus 0.75 minus 0.02. Log 10 is 1. So it is minus 0.77 volts. So this is the answer. What is this? This is the reduction potential. If you want the oxidation potential, so this is reduction potential what you have obtained. Suppose you want for oxidation potential, this is plus 0.77 volts oxidation potential. Okay students, let us take some more questions with respect to this model. Okay, students, here are some questions. Right, two more questions. What is it? Find the area of the cell, chromium magnet and chromium plus 3, Fe plus 2 converted to Fe. Right? Where E naught of chromium plus 3 to chromium. So, this is the reaction value. T1 of cell minus 0.059 by length log products by reactant concentration. This is very clear. Right here, you doesn't have a single electrode, you are having entire cell. So first try to write the equation for this. So what's happening here? Chromium getting converted to chromium plus 3 plus 3 electrons. This is undergoing oxidation. And this one, it is undergoing reaction. So it is Fe plus 2 plus 2 electrons. It gets converted to Fe. Can you cancel these two equations? You can't cancel. Why? Because we require same number of electrons to cancel. So multiply this equation with 3 and this equation with 2. What it becomes? 2 times of chromium, 2Cr plus 3 plus 6 electrons. This one, 3 Fe plus 2 plus 6 electrons used to 3 Fe. Now can we add this 2? Yes. 6 electrons cancel. 2 chromium, 3 Fe plus 2, 2Cr plus 3 plus 3 Fe. So this is the equation. Now you want the equilibrium constant for this. How to make the equilibrium constant is called concentration of products. What is the concentration of products? Chromium plus 3 square Fe power cube by this one Fe plus 2 cube chromium square. So this is the way of writing the products by carbon reactant. So this one you should keep here. But you know that this is solid, right? Iron is solid. Here iron is solid, not Fe plus 2. Okay, and chromium is solid. So how can I take equilibrium to be equal to Cr plus 3 whole square by Fe plus 2 whole cube? This is called the reaction because these two can be, this one and this one can be cancelled. What is Cr plus 2 concentration? Cr plus 2 concentration is 0.1 whole square. By Fe plus 2 concentration, Fe plus 3 is 0.01, but it is not whole cube. So this value will be placed here. Okay? First, this one should write in the form of the equation. And you know that products should be the excess concentration. Products are going to have the solids, it will be taken as the unity. And concentration of Cr plus 3 has been mentioned. Cr plus 3 has been mentioned as 0.1, and Fe plus 3 has been mentioned as 0.01. Right? And then this one will be placed here. So, next is, this one is okay, minus 0.059. How many electrons are being involved? 6 electrons, not 2 or 3. These 6 electrons. So, this is log, this one, 0.R given as 10 power minus 1 whole square by 10 power minus 2 whole. This is 10 power minus 2. Okay. E0 of cell. What is E0 of cell? What is E0 of cell? E0 of cell, you know that. What is E0 of cell? E0 of cell is nothing but E0 of RHS minus E of LHS. Okay, E0. What is RHS? I think RHS, I will tell you, is minus 0.45. What is LHS value? This is RHS, LHS. LHS is minus 0.7. So it is minus 0.45 plus 0.75. So it will be 0.30. So this is the E0 of the cell. Okay, E0 of cell. This is not single electrode because the hydrogen is, right? This is the entire thing is one cell. So you will get here E0 of cell. E0 is 0.30. So it will be 0.30 minus again 0.06 by 6. Okay, log 10 power minus 2 by 10 power minus 6. If you get stop, you will get 10 power 4, 0.30, 0.06 by 6, log 10 power 4. You will be getting plus 6 again, plus 6 plus 4 you will be getting. So, this is 0.01, 0.30 minus 0.01 into 4 log 10. So, it is 4. So, it is 0.30 minus 0.04. So, as will be 0.264. Getting first condition. Okay, again I am repeating, answer this is 0.26 volts. I am repeating the identity. See, first whenever you get the entire equation, the entire thing. This is the entire cell. For this, you write the equation. So, chromium has been converted to chromium residue. Chromium has been converted to chromium residue plus 3 electrons. Plus, electrons are more of 3. In this condition, Fe plus 2 getting converted to Fe. So, Fe plus 2 plus 2 electrons is just converted to Fe. Going on adding two equations, you can't add because the electrons are different there. So that you make a common electron, so that you get it. You multiply into 2 and into 3, you get it equal to this equation. And final equation is 2 chromium plus 3 Fe plus 2 plus 2 SO2 Cr plus 3 plus 3 Fe. Right? Solids are making as cancer and whatever they remain, you are making as equilibrium constant. So this is 2 Cr, Cr plus the whole square, Fe whole cube, Fe plus 2 whole cube, Cr whole square. Right? So Fe and Cr can be cancer because those two are solids and the remaining thing, the concentration minus Cr is given, you can place this one here. You will be getting here. And E naught of cell you should calculate. E naught cell of cell means DRH is minus NSS. So finally 0.30 volt you will be getting. You place this one here. Okay. Solve the entire equation and you will be getting answer as 0.26 volt. I hope that you have understood this. The same model here also. Another question. Try to solve this. Okay. The question is as follows. What is cell? Find the income of the cell at 25 degrees centigrade. Zinc converted to ZL plus 2, SL plus 2 converted to SL. Okay? E naught of ZL plus 2 is ZL. So this is got reduction value and this one SL plus 2 is SL. So it is also reduction value. Both are reduction values and that is the equation. So what is our first condition? See, pass over the first one is and you try to solve. Okay? Okay, I hope that you have got the answer. Otherwise, you go through this. First condition is first you should write the equation for this reaction. So, ZL. Getting converted to ZL plus 2 plus 2 electrons. This one, SL plus 2 plus 2 electrons gets converted to this. This is the condition. Now, can we add these two equations? Yes, definitely we can add because common electrons are there, 2 electrons. So, zinc plus SL plus 2 converted to ZL plus 2 plus 2. And this is the equation, 2 electrons will cancel. So, it goes for the equilibrium constant, okay? So equilibrium constant will be concentration of ZL plus 2, concentration of zinc by concentration of SL plus 2, concentration of zinc. You know that these two are solids when you do that, so equilibrium will be equal to concentration of ZL plus 2. What is the concentration of ZL plus 2? ZL plus 2 is 10 power minus 1, what will be calculated in whole squares. And SL plus 2 is this 10 power minus 1. So this is the equilibrium constant, so that what you mean? So it is 10 power minus 1, it comes into 10 power 3. So the final answer will be cancelled. So A equilibrium will be equal to 10 square. So we know that E is equal to E naught of E of cell. Is equal to E naught of cell minus 0.059 by N log product concentration by reactor's concentration. Clear? Okay, what is the product now? For concentration by reactor concentration already we have got it as cell square. So it is, what is E naught of cell? E naught of cell is nothing but, say I can have written here, E naught of cell. E naught is nothing but E RHS minus E naught of LHS. What is RHS? RHS is starting, so it is minus 0.14 minus of LHS. LHS is zinc, so it is minus 0.7. So it becomes minus 0.14 plus 0.76. So it becomes, this is 4 goes, this 2, 7, 1, 6, right? 0.626. Right. 0.62 volts is that E naught of this cell. Okay? So E naught of this cell I am writing here as 0.62 minus 0.059 by how many electrons are being involved? Only 2 electrons are being involved, right? Don't take as 4, it is only 2. Log 10 square. Is it clear? So it is 0.62 minus 0.059 by 2. Log 2 is 2. Cancel. So it becomes. We take 0.62. Right. Minus. We take it as 0.06. We will take it wrong. We take it here right. 0.05. So whatever you calculate, it will be 0.620, 0.059. So it's as it is 0.561 volts. This is the pattern of doing the questions with respect to this one. Right? I hope that you are getting this. First thing is you should write the equation. Second thing is you should calculate the E0. Calculate these two values and substitute this equation. Then automatically you will be getting the EMF of this cell. Right? See students, before here, you are getting 5 questions here. See, this is JEE Advanced 2016 question. Right? So, E of cell. Now we need to calculate the number of cell. Already has given. And here we say platinum has taken electrode. Platinum is in the electrode, it will not react. So, generally the reaction of number is H2. H2 converting to H2. Since it is undergoing oxidation, some metal is taking. It is undergoing as reduction. Hydrogen undergoing oxidation, metal is undergoing reduction. If the platinum has electrode, platinum is not going to react. Platinum is only going to electrode. These hydrogen and hydrogen is not reacting. Hydrogen is undergoing oxidation, metal is undergoing reduction. Right? So, E0 of metal is given. This goes to this zone. This is reduction. This is 0. Reduction. Okay. The value of hydrogen is 0. See, remember this one. I am writing it in the upcoming time. This is taken as standard electrode. Okay? Okay. Remember that the value is written as 0. F+2/N+4 gas taken as 10 more x. What is the value of x? This is the question. Okay? The same pattern, whatever you order, go in the same way. Pass the video, try to solve the question. Okay. I am solving this. Right? I hope that you have got the answer. Solution is like this. First, write the equation of condition is H2. Getting converted into 2H+2 electrons. This is the oxidation. This one. M+4+2 electrons getting converted into M+2. This is the way. 2 electrons you can add to these things. H2+M+4 gives to 2H+10^+2. So if you write the equilibrium constant, it will be H+2M+2/1. So you know that coefficient should become the power. And this is M+4/1 and H2/1. So you know that equilibrium constant is nothing but product concentration by reaction product concentration. What is H+ concentration? H+ concentration we have coefficient as 1. So it is 1^2. So we keep this one as this. So this is the thing what you have done. Next condition, what you should do? This is nothing but equal to product concentration by reactant concentration. The next thing is you should calculate the E0 of cell. What is E0 of cell? E RHS - E LHS. What is RHS value? This is RHS 0.151 minus LHS value. LHS value is 0. So as a blue line, 0.151. Right. This is the E0 of cell. First thing is write the equation, balance the electrons, write the equation, then you write the form of equilibrium constant, the concentration of the products, then the concentration of the reactants. Right? Next, E0 of cell. Now go for the equation. E of cell is equal to E0 of cell minus 0.059 by the log concentration of products by concentration of reactants. This is the condition. Right. What is E of cell? E of cell has been as 0.092. E0 of cell 0.151 minus 0.059 by N. It is 2 because 2 electrons are being involved. Log. So, products by reactants. This is the condition. So, H+2/M+2/1 by H2/1 M+4. Okay? 0.092.51 minus 0.059 by 2 log. This is H+ is H+. One more concentration, so 1^2. M+2/M+4. This condition M+2/M+4. This one 10^x by H2. and so much, 1 bar gas is required. So we'll be reading 0.092, 0.151 and 0.05982. This is 10 borax degree. 10 borax means only ETS. So you said this value is set. Calculate the value of yes. So what happens? 0.092 minus 0.151. Okay? What it becomes? Right. Minus 0.0592. Yes. So this is 0. So 0.059 is equal to minus. Okay. 0.059 by 2. So x value is equal to 2. Let me about the result here. 10 power equals to 8, 2. Okay. Right. So the final answer is 2. Okay, getting me? So look over the next question. Right. AG plus 0.1 concentration, AG plus and AG. This is 2 more concentration and AG on the set. See, this is, we should be very cautious. What is mean by E0? E0 is nothing but the standard electrode potential at 25 degrees centigrade. This is clear. Standard electrode potential at 25 degrees centigrade is called as E0 of the cell. Right? First condition is, we should calculate the what? Go for the reaction. So this one AG. AG getting converted to AG plus. What is the concentration? It is 0.2 molar. Plus 1 electron. This is the simple thing because already this is the oscillation and this is reduction. AG plus electron, it is then converted to AG. So what is the concentration? This is 2 molar concentration. Okay? This is the question. You can add this to because you are having only 1 electron and either side. So AG AG can cancel. Because this is the solid thing, this is the solid thing. Or nothing happens, you can keep this up. This should not be cancelled AG plus because the concentration is different. This is 0.2 molar concentration and this is 2 molar concentration. So if you won't cancel, then it will be like this. AG plus 2 molar concentration gives rise to AG plus 0.2 molar concentration plus AG. If you write the equation, K equilibrium constant, how do you mean? K equilibrium constant will be called AG plus. This is AG. This is 0.2 molar concentrations. And this one, AG plus. See, AG is being cancelled because this was solid. This is that way also it is solid. So this is AG plus. This should not cancel because the concentration is different. AG plus is this one. So it is 0.2 molar is the concentration by AG plus. It is 2 molar. So what happens? What is the reactance? So it becomes 0.1. So next our reaction is equal to E0 of cell minus 0.059 by N log products by N. This is the equation. What is the E0 of the cell? E0 of the cell will be 0 because here the electrons both are the same. Both electrons are similar only. At 25 degrees centigrade the electron potential will be the same value. So RHS minus LHS for silver. It will be same because one will be oscillation value, other will be the reaction value. If you get this one plus 10, this one minus 10 will be getting. Okay? If you cancel, it will become again 0. Reduction potential and oscillation potential. The values are same, but they will be the same, right? So on total, what will be E0 of the cell? This is generally E of RHS minus E of LHS. At standard conditions. Standard conditions means the value whatever this one will be, this one will be also the same. Okay, if you get oscillation value, we will be out of the set, right? So these two should be equal to 0. So E0 of 1 should be equal to 0. Of the summation of these two things, we will be getting the value as 0. Because E0 of the same material you are taking. So if it is one hydrogen, if it is simple, you will be getting some value. If it is zinc, if it is chromium, you will be getting. If it is simple, it is static. Status, okay, you will be getting. But both are same things. Like E0 of the same will be equal to 0 because both are the same. So E is equal to 0 minus 0.059 by 1 log. What is price of concentration? That is 10 power minus 1. So this is minus 1. So E will be equal to 0 minus 0.059 by 1 into minus 1. So So E will be equal to 0.059 volts. Getting me?
When E not will be 0 means E not will be 0 when cathode and anode are same materials. When E will be 0? This one. When this one will be 0 means at equilibrium.
Derivation. Okay, when delta G is equal to 0, then E will be equal to 0. Okay, when delta G naught is equal to 0, E naught will be equal to 0.
Getting E naught equal to 0 means delta G naught equal to 0. Here equilibrium condition. Whenever there is an equilibrium condition, E will be equal to 0. When E naught will be 0 means when we take same material or when delta G naught is equal to 0. This is known as cathode and anode are the same material, then E naught will be equal to 0. This one means we will mention there will be a condition, so where the equilibrium is existing, find the calculate, we will be asking to find out the E naught at standard conditions. But the action will be in equilibrium. Okay, this is the condition. See, remember once again I am telling E will be 0 when there is an equilibrium condition. Equilibrium they will mention. Okay, when E naught will be 0, when both the materials are the same. So these are the types of the problems what you can expect with respect to the Nernst equation. Majorly 90% only these models will be coming to the examinations, right? Okay students, now let us go with respect to one more electrode that is called as sheet or it is called as condensation. Sheet means standard hydrogen electrode, or this is also called as normal hydrogen electrode. See, she or me, she means standard hydrogen electrode, me means normal hydrogen electrode. This is the reference point. Okay, suppose if I ask you, like, if you are having 1 lakh rupees, what you mean I am having 1 lakh rupees? Means when compared to 1 rupee, you are having 1 lakh times greater. So, rupee is the reference point. Getting me? Suppose if you say 10 rupees, means if you compare to 1 rupee, you are having 10 times extra. 10 times you are having to compare to rupee. Suppose if you are having 1000, means compared to rupee you are having 1000. If I say half rupee, compared to 1 rupee I am having half in it. Okay? So rupee is the reference point for money. So for electrodes, hydrogen electrode is the reference point. So zinc you are comparing with hydrogen, it will be having some value. Copper you are comparing with zinc, with hydrogen you are having some value. So always the electrode potential will be compared with the standard hydrogen electrode. Based on that, we will be doing that. Okay, see here how the hydrogen electrode is constructed. So, you are taking the container, okay, in which you are taking 1 molar HCl. Concentration. Now, you are taking a cube. But if you make you in this the platinum white, this is platinum white, at the base you are taking a platinum foil. That means this is platinum white and it is attached with the platinum foil. Okay, this wire is like this. If you like this, what you are doing is from this gap you are sending H2 gas. A platinum white is living with a platinum foil which has been immersed in 1 molar HCl solution. Now you are sending H2 gas into this one. So this platinum foil is coated with black light. Coated with
black color. So it is called as platinum black foil. Okay, so taking platinum sheet, you are coating with black paint, right? That is related to the platinum foil. It is immersed in a tube, inverted tube, where you are sending hydrogen gas onto this foil. What happens? This foil, you know that black is the absorber of all colors. And white is the emitter of all colors. Black and white are not colors. Okay? Black and white are not colors. Black means a substance which absorbs all the radiations of the light. It is black in color. We will be telling this black, but not black and white. It is black. Okay? Any substance which emits all the radiations, then that is white in nature. Right? So as you have painted it with black, so how much the hydrogen gas you are sending onto this foil, it will be getting absorbed. Okay? H2 is absorbed on the foil. If it is a steam mole, what happens? If it is having capacity to take 10 moles of hydrogen, it takes 10 moles. After that, what happens? It will use the remaining gas. Okay, whatever the extra gas is there, apart from the absorbed one, the remaining H2 gas will be coming outside. Okay, H2 gas comes outside. Whatever the capacity is having, they absorb the same thing and the remaining it is into the container. Right? So this is called as the standard hydrogen electrode. Okay? This is the way of constructing the standard hydrogen electrode. And what are the uses? What you can say? It acts this hydrogen electrode, it acts as both cathode and anode. It acts as both cathode and anode. So better it approaches like anode. You know, it behaves as anode, it will be a reaction. So H2 gets converted to H2. So it has a lot of oxidation. This hydrogen electrode, whenever it acts as anode, it approaches in this way. So whenever it approaches, whenever it is like cathode, it undergoes reaction in this pattern. Whenever the hydrogen electrode acts as anode, it undergoes oxidation. So, 0 oxidation to 0 plus 1 has been increased. Whenever it behaves as cathode, so it undergoes reaction. Okay? Then, what do we call? The value for both the thing. So, E0 of H2, it is converted to 2H2S, is equal to 0. We are taking this one as the reference point. When compared to this one, you will be getting the value. And this one now, E0. Getting 2H+2, H2, it is sigma. See, this is oxidation value, this is reduction value. Even though it undergoes oxidation, the value is taken as 0. Even though it undergoes reduction, the value is taken as 0. Why we are constructing this one? This one, it acts as both anode and cathode, that's why we are using this one, and it acts as a reference point. It acts as a reference. Okay? Reference. Electrode gasing, it acts as the reference electrode. So she or me acts as reference electrode. It acts as both anode and cathode. For the oxidation, it is converted in this way. For reduction, it is converted in this way. So whenever it behaves as cathode, there will be a reduction of hydrogen gas. Whenever a single standard hydrogen electrode behaves as cathode, there will be a reduction of H2 gas. Whenever it behaves as anode, there is no reduction of H2 gas. There is only the concentration term that has been left out. Right? So this is the way of constructing the electrode and what it is doing. So what is the use of this one? So generally the use of this standard hydrogen electrode is you can calculate the observed electrode potential. You can calculate uses. You can calculate absolute potential of an electrode. See, you can calculate the absolute potential of an electrode by using this. Suppose if I want to calculate the electrode potential of this thing, what I will do? I will take one container. So, zinc sulfate solution. So, this is zinc rod. Then I have connected zinc with this one. Zinc is undergoing precipitation. So what is happening here? So zinc undergoing oxidation. Now what is should I do? If this is behaving as anode, this one will behave as cathode. So here cathode is 2H plus plus 2 electron, this is H2 gas. So this is the reaction. Zn plus 2H plus this plus 2, Zn plus 2 plus H2. So this is the equation what is going. So the electrons are moving in this direction. Electrons are moving in this direction. Because this is acting as anode, it is liberating electrons, the electrons are moving like this, goes the current goes in the opposite direction. Getting me? Zinc is compared with the hydrogen electron. Now if I say, what is the E naught of cell? Means E naught of RHS minus E naught of LHS. Which is undergoing reduction? RHS should undergo reduction. This is the condition. This is undergoing reduction. So this value is equal to 0 minus RHS. So we will be getting value of S. Let us assume the value of S. So what is the E naught of zinc? Is nothing but minus 6 value of S. Because we are getting this as water. This one is 0. So whatever the value you are getting, then it is the value of zinc itself. So zinc value you are getting here. Electro potential of zinc is calculated. Suppose if I use copper here, this is the connection with zinc. Suppose if I use instead of zinc, if I use copper. So I am getting here copper sulfate solution. And this is copper. Okay? Copper sulfate solution and copper. So when I use like this, this one is undergoing oxidation, this is undergoing reduction. Getting me? When I am using copper as copper sulfate, this one is undergoing oxidation. And this is undergoing reduction. Okay? So what happens? The electrons do not be in this moment, in this way, the current is in this pattern. So if I assume that this is in this pattern, then I have connected practically. This one, what is happening? This is undergoing oxidation, right? So what is the reaction for this oxidation means? So H2 getting converted to 2H plus plus 2 electrons. What happened here is undergoing reduction. So it is copper plus 2 electrons getting converted to copper. So this is the reaction. So it will be copper plus 2 plus H2, electrons cancel, 2H plus plus copper. So this is the reaction and the way of representation. H2 converted to H plus. The first class you can write as 2H plus, nothing copper. Next, this one is copper plus 2, copper. If I go for the zinc, so what happens? Zn converted to Zn plus 2. This is H plus converted to H2. This is the condition. So in this case, it is behaving as anode. In this case, it is behaving as cathode. Here it is undergoing oxidation, here it is undergoing reduction. So in this, what happens? If you want to calculate for copper, E of cell will be equal to E naught of RHS minus E naught of LHS. So what is RHS? If copper is undergoing RHS, so it is Y assuming minus LHS is right in this one, right? This is zero. So what will be the E naught of the cell? E naught of the cell will be equal to Y. This is the standard electron potential of what? It is copper. For copper, it is the standard hydrogen. You are giving standard electron potential. Why you are giving means you have given copper with the help of, and this is taken as zero. In one case it is undergoing oxidation, in one case it is undergoing reaction. Okay? So everything. Now once we have connected here zinc, once copper, once iron, once tin, once lead, once gold. So all metals, this one is taken as zero and you are replacing this one. So then whatever the electron potential you are getting, you will be getting the electron potential of the metal itself. Metal or non-metal, whatever you are bringing here. You have bromine, chlorine, fluorine, iodine, silver, sodium, magnesium, lithium, potassium, rubidium, this one, this is changed and this is taken as a reference point. Because this acts as both cathode and anode, and this is the reference point, so that whatever the EMF you are getting, that EMF will be the electron potential of the particular respective cell only. Because this one is taken as zero. Okay? Now can you know the importance of this one? Yes, this is taken as zero. By taking this as zero, we can know the electron potential of copper, we can know the electron potential of zinc, we can know the electron potential of any metal or non-metal, whatever we are looking here. This is the main use of standard hydrogen electrode. See, again I'm telling hydrogen electrode, it can undergo both oxidation as well as reduction. Okay? Based on that, you will be getting the electron potential value. So by using like this,
when I need two things, see, zinc is giving electrons here. Okay, so it is acting as anode. Copper is acting as cathode because it is taking electrons. So if I list all of these, which are taking electrons and which are giving electrons to the hydrogen, then I will get one series. That series is called as electrochemical series. You should by heart that series. No way. You can remember it in the form of a song or anything. Right? So that series, whatever you are getting, taking reference as the hydrogen electrode, that series it is called as electrochemical series. So, electrochemical series. Okay, students, let me draw the electrochemical students, electrochemical series. How it will be just an outer and drawing. You should remember all the things in respect of, you should buy half the same things. Generally, 9% they will ask. If they ask, you should remember. Okay? See, let me write that. Look over here, students. You are having the electrochemical series. Electrochemical series, this is the order. See, generally, I have already told this, sir. But there are many. You follow the NCERT textbook, it's more than enough. I have given some examples, right? So, the electrochemical series, increasing order. Okay? See here, -3.05. The value is compared to zinc. This value, the potassium will be greater than this value. If you go on like this, it will be increasing. See here, it is -0.76. See here, -3.05 is -0.76. So the value has been increased, the negative numbers, right? The value has been increased from zinc to here, you get. It is -0.45. It has been increased from 0.45. It has come to 0. It has been increased again. From here to here. Again, the value is going on increasing. So this is the order. Okay? As you go down, see, generally this is the condition. You know, this two, last year and this year, I think, it has been reversed. Okay? But last, all questions is the same pattern. What you know, this it has been doing is first we have been this value. The other one is reverse pattern. Okay? In more books, the people use the pencil in this pattern. So lithium, potassium, barium, strontium, like that. So what happens? I am following this one. As you go down, SRP value increases. See, from lithium to potassium you are going, means the SRP value increases. So from lithium to barium, potassium to barium, when compare potassium and barium, barium will be having higher SRP value. Barium is strontium, this one will be having higher SRP value. So as you go down the series, like this, below this one, what is happening? The capacity or the standard potential value is increasing. Means tendency to gain electrons. To gain electrons is increasing. Okay, it is getting reduced, means it is taking electrons. Reduction means electrons, right? So tendency to get reduced increases. Okay? So what happens? So to behave as oxidizing agent, to behave as oxidizing agent increases. This is one thing. From top to bottom you are getting, right? Getting in. So from top to bottom we get the reaction SRP value increases. If SRP value increases, what happens? Tendency to withdraw the electrons increases. Electrons increasing means the reducing agent is increasing, so that anything which undergoes reduction is called as oxidizing agent. Okay? Anything which undergoes reduction, it is called as oxidizing agent. Anything which undergoes oxidation, it is called as reducing agent. So this is the condition. It will be reversed from here to here. If you go from down to bottom, this one will be reversed. As you go up, the SRP value decreases. Tendency to gain electrons decreases. Tendency to get reduced decreases. To behave as oxidizing agent. Okay, it is all in the reverse pattern. Main thing is, if I talk from top to bottom, the upper one will go, will behave as anode, and the bottom one will behave as cathode. Remember this thing. The upper one will behave as anode. Suppose if I want to construct a cell between these two. Okay? Between these two, which one will behave as anode? This lithium will behave as anode, and this one will behave as cathode. See, among these two, this behaves as anode, and this behaves as cathode. Suppose if I want to construct the cell between lithium and the strontium, this one will behave as anode, this one will behave as cathode. Getting me? Suppose if I want to Right. Suppose if I want to measure between these two, cobalt and nickel, which will behave as anode and which will behave as cathode. So this one will behave as anode and this one will behave as cathode. Then only the construction of the cell is possible because you get the E value positive. To get E value positive, E value positive means G value will be negative. So that becomes spontaneous. Right? So because this one is spontaneous, G should be negative. Okay? G, in the case, it should be negative. To be G negative, it should be positive. To be E positive, the upper one should behave as anode and the lower one should behave as cathode. If this one behaves as anode and this one behaves as cathode, that cell is non spontaneous. Okay? How we can expect questions? See, when you make to that, suppose if I make to that, this to the end, what happens? This one will behave as anode, this one will behave as cathode. If this behaves as cathode, will there be limitation of H2 gas? Yes. There will be limitation of H2 gas. Suppose write the equation for these two. See, this one is behaving as anode, right? And this one is behaving as cathode. Yeah. PB, converted to PB plus 2. Solve which? H2 gas. Converted to H2. Because this is another observation, this is another reaction, we are getting out H2 gas. Okay. Suppose if I consider these two, hydrogen with copper. Okay, hydrogen with copper. If hydrogen with copper, there is no limitation of hydrogen gas. Why there is no limitation of hydrogen gas? Because it is behaving as anode. So, here the reaction will be hydrogen like this. Copper plus 2, copper. See, it is behaving as water. Anode. So, whenever hydrogen behaves as anode, it will not liberate hydrogen gas. It will not behave as cathode. So, below this, all these metals, all these non-metals will not liberate hydrogen gas because they are below the hydrogen atom. So whenever it is below the hydrogen atom, hydrogen will behave as anode, this will behave as cathode. So among these two, anode, this is cathode. Among these two, anode, this is cathode. Among these two, this one anode, this is cathode. Right? So this is the use of constructing the electrochemical cell. So this is the way. So in the electrochemical cell is top to bottom, if SRP increases, the upper one will behave as anode and the bottom one will behave as cathode. Let us take some examples so that we will be winding up this from this chapter. See, students, I have two questions. X value, X is the element which is having 0.5 volts, Y is minus 3.003 volts, it is going to minus 1.18 volts. Order of reducing power. Reducing power is nothing but reducing agent. Okay? So, if I go for the solution, first, you write whatever you have given, you write in the form of decreasing order. Sorry, increasing order of value. So you get minus 3.0. So first one, this one is minus 3.03 volts. Next one, Z, it is minus 1.18 volts. This is increasing order. And next one is X. So it is 0.5. We know that among these three, recovered this one, we have an anode cathode. This one, among these two, this is anode, this is cathode. Among these two, this is anode, this is cathode. Okay, reducing power means reducing power or reducing agent, both are same. Okay, so what happens? Reducing agent are below the top, bottom to bottom increases. Okay, the positive value is getting positive value. This one is the anomalous reduction. Okay, this one is the anomalous reduction, this is oscillating agent. It will cause the occurrence. If it is oscillating agent, this is reducing. So, reducing agent always this one. Okay? Y, Z, X. So, if I say oscillating power or oscillating agent, what happens? From top to bottom, which one should undergo oscillation? Which one undergo is the oscillation system? So, X, sorry, this one from here to here, this is the anomalous reduction. From top to bottom, reduction is the anomalous. We get the positive value, right? This is reduction, so this is oxidizing agent. So oxidizing agent is more X compared to Z compared to Y. So this is the answer we ask for the reducing power. Reducing power means reducing agent. Okay? Right. Next question. Find the
0.00. If it becomes 0, it becomes 2 into 0.05. So this is 0.05. So what is the express concentration? This is 0.1. So this express concentration is 0.1. That is what you mentioned.
Okay, and ask them to calculate the electron potential. Electron potential means what is very easy. H plus, plus 2 electrons. It gets converted to H2. This is the condition. Okay, E is equal to E of electrode will be equal to E naught of electrode minus 0.059 by L log 1 of the point concentration is H2 by you can't go for concentration here because H2 is a gas, so you can go for partial H2 pressure. Gas by H plus 6.5. 2 electrons will be there, then there are 2 electrons in one. So E is equal to what is E naught? E naught of hydrogen electrode are cancelled, right? So it is 0 minus 0.059 by number of electrons on the electrode. Log. What is the partial condition? Unit gas, another partial gas. So it is 1 by h plus square. What is h plus? 0.1. So it becomes 10 power minus 2. 10 power minus 1 to 10 power minus 1. Because 10 power minus 1 goes square. So it becomes 12. What happens? 0.059 by 2 into log square. 10 square. So it is log 10 square. So minus 0.059 by 2 into 2. This will be cancelled, so answer is minus 0.059 volts. This is the electrode potential of this one. So this is what for today's students. Have a nice day. Hope that you have understood all the things well. By this half of the chapter, that is what the conversion of chemical energy into electricity. Okay, those are called as electrochemical cells. Conversion of chemical energy into electricity, those are called as electrochemical cells or galvanic cells. These have been completed. And the remaining chapter where by using electricity we are getting chemicals, those cells are called as electrolytic cells. Okay, by using current we will provide current, we will be getting chemicals. In this condition we are using chemicals, we are getting current. Okay, chemicals are being given, we are getting current. So the remaining chapter is called electrolytic cells. We will be continuing the next session. This is what for the this session. Have a nice day. Stay home, stay safe. Bye.